name is Donna Hicks, and first of all, I'd just like to say how excited and grateful we are to be a part of this call to unite. And so let me just start by telling you what dignity is. In my definition of it, it's very simple. Dignity is just our inborn value and worth. Every human being comes into the world with dignity. But the problem is most people haven't even thought about dignity in those terms, especially in terms of the suffering that they've endured. So one of the things that has been so helpful in the work that I do in trying to heal these underlying dignity wounds is to give them some language, how to talk about these wounds to your dignity. But I would also like to answer the call here by having us look in these times of isolation and these scary times that we're all going through with so much uncertainty. How can we use this time productively and positively? And the other thing I'd like us to ask ourselves during this session is, do I feel unconditionally worthy in this moment in time and in all times? How is the health of my dignity? So I hope by the end of our session here, this short session, that we can all say, yes, I know I'm unconditionally worthy. I was born with dignity. So these 10 elements of dignity that I'm going to take you through right now, they're a product of about 20 years of work around trying to identify how to put a language to them. And I interviewed people from all over the world. And the result of all of those interviews for several years was what I call the 10 elements of dignity. So here they are. The first element of dignity is everybody wants to have their identity accepted. Everybody wants to feel that they're equal in dignity. Now, we may differ in status, but we are equal in dignity. Second thing is recognition. We all want recognition of our unique qualities and way of life. Third, acknowledgement. When we have gone through a very difficult situation, when we have experienced pain and suffering, we want acknowledgement. The fourth one is inclusion. Everybody wants to feel a sense of belonging. We don't like feeling like we're out on the margins of society. We all want that wonderful sense of being embraced and belonging. The fifth one is safety. And it's not just physical safety, although that's important, but it's also psychological safety. We want to feel safe to be our authentic selves. We want to feel safe to speak up when something bad has happened to us. Sixth is fairness. Well, this is a no-brainer. Everybody wants to be treated fairly in an even-handed way. Seven is independence. We want that feeling of being in control of our lives and being able to manage in creating possibilities for us when we feel like we're micromanaged or somebody's hovering over us. It's really a terrible feeling. We want to be in control of our lives. The eighth one is understanding. We want to be able to be understood. We want our perspective known. We want people to say, gee, tell me more about who you are. Nine is benefit of the doubt. People want to be treated as trustworthy and feeling like they have integrity. And the final one is accountability. And sometimes I think this is the hardest, and that is to say, I'm sorry. So here are these 10 elements of dignity. If we could think of this as a positive way of spending, you know, these periods of isolation that we're all in. If we could just take a look at these 10 elements of dignity and say, how has this been for me in my life? How have these 10 elements of dignity been honored? And if they haven't been honored, how can I identify them and actually begin the healing process? So that's a very concrete way of taking a look at some of the suffering that you might have endured, not only just the suffering in your life, but this current suffering that we're all experiencing right now. And now I would like to turn to my dear friend and colleague, Federica Vegas, who is living in the Dominican Republic and who has taken my dignity workshops at the Harvard Divinity School twice. And she made a commitment to do dignity workshops in the Dominican Republic with women who have suffered a lot of pain and heartache. So, Federica, I'm going to turn it over to you now to talk about your experiences with dignity healing.
Thank you, Donna. Hello, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here and be part of this call to unite at this hard times. We find ourselves in disconnection, isolated, far away from people we love. We're experiencing hard emotions and feelings, anxiety, worry. And I know what those feelings can do to you because I've lived them throughout my life. And the dignity model was the way out. It's the tool I found in life, the gift to overcome them. And that is why we are answering this call by spreading this powerful message of dignity. So I would like to tell you a little bit about why it is so powerful and valuable, and even more now. And as Donna said, I attended her workshops at the Harvard Divinity School for 2 years in a row, and it was a transformative experience because as I learned about the model she created, it allowed me to finally put words around all the hard things I had been through. I could understand why they were wrong. Not that I was crazy, too sensitive, but that there was a reason for my pain. And I saw that those experiences I had gone through were dignity violations. And that in itself, just being able to name it, explained why it had hurt so badly. It's a journey. It's an incredible journey. And that process, going through it, returned my worth to me. And now I dedicate my life, as Donna told you, to do this work, spread this message. And I do workshops with women, teaching them the dignity model. And every time I do them, as soon as I introduce the concept of dignity, as just Donna did, and the 10 elements, it feels as if magic enters the room. And everyone is suddenly able to speak. They're open to talk about what they've been through. It legitimizes their experiences. They understand that they have been treated unfairly, that it should not have happened. And most importantly, the idea that their dignity has been violated, but has not been taken away. And that empowers from deep within. It becomes just almost like a superpower that helps you build a connection to your inner self, to your worth. And you get a sense of groundness, of inner stability that I think we're all craving now. And you realize it's yours and nothing or nobody can take it away. So I invite you to go through that experience, read the elements, analyze them in your life, what you've been through, how you relate to others, and live this yourself. And I want to close by saying that one of the most beautiful things I've seen through this work is that as you understand your emotions, your story, you acknowledge and accept what you've been through, that opens your heart to others in a beautiful, loving, and deep way. And here's where I find such hope, that even though this is a hard moment we're all going through, but with it comes a huge opportunity. And if we do this type of work and we find deep connection to ourselves and to other human beings, I'm sure we'll get out of this with unity and with love. Mm-hmm. So thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you so much. That's just beautiful. And I would like to close by thinking about, after this is all over, if we were to ask ourselves, what did I do to make a positive contribution to this aching world that we're all living in? And I think if we can answer it by saying, I tried my best to honor my own dignity, to honor the dignity of everybody that I come in contact with. Because what we really want and yearn for in this upheaval is we want those deep connections with other people. And I'll tell you, the one way to connect with others is by honoring their dignity. So I hope we can all say, yep, we did our best. We really tried, and we tried to put more dignity into the world. And at the end of the day, I can also tell you that I don't think, as Federica so beautifully pointed out, once we make these connections with our dignity and the dignity of others, this is where unity lives. But I really don't think that we can have unity without dignity. So good luck with this, and thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you.